LA High. It's the best spot in the world. And there was like kind of a while where this was the only spot I was going to.
Let's go.
Well, I used to live like not too far from here, and there was not a ton to skate on that side of town, and then we would just be here a lot, Jerry and I. And... Early 20s, I had a couple of knee surgeries. I just like did a shitty job of recovering. I just like couldn't ollie onto shit right for so long, and so I would just skate banks, but I was just fucking jamming into this fucker, probably making it so much worse. Yeah! Hardest trick, probably the back tail backside flip. That's the only time it's worked, is when you can like treat it like a wally, like go weightless to the top. You like get that in your gut and your hips and stuff. Like when people come here and then like are really disappointed by the way it feels, and they would like get here and be like, this thing sucks. I would get like a sense of pride. Like, yeah, that's right. This thing, I like that they don't like it.
Spanky, like number one, is just like the most friendly guy, but I would say I would describe Spanky as almost like a happiness addict or something like that. Like,
I mean, the last 3 weeks have been much as stacked as I hope they'll ever be. You know, it's been pretty nonstop. You've come at a really busy time. Today we're just we're just fucking around. Yeah, like lately it's been a little bit more getting serious in the streets, and a little less just going out and having fun. And today's been a just having fun day.
Kevin could very easily just be like just an Instagram skater these days. Like, I think his sponsors would be like, yeah, dude, like do your thing. That's really all we need from you. But he stays so active, like actually going out and doing the like real street skating and that kind of thing. So like, I think that just is one of those things where you're like, oh wow, he's like still filming video parts and he's being this active like on Instagram. Like, how does he do it? How does he like have enough time to do it?
I can see your face there.
Oh no!
Baby report. She's ball shopping. Now I think she might be a jock. The Instagram thing is a really interesting part of skateboarding right now, I think, is that a lot of skaters are kind of expected to put a lot of stuff out on Instagram, and I was just trying to like make it a little bit more personal if I was going to post it and feel like a little hand in it in a creative way. Just how skateboarders have a hand in their graphics or clothes they put out or their shoe design or whatever. It's just like taking photos of my surroundings and who I'm with and my everyday life, and just maybe make somebody's head big or make them have gigantic pants or like a little tiny head or something, like big hands or some shit, like switch the baby's face with a dog or something. Don't eat that. Don't eat it.
You know, I wouldn't necessarily say that he's changed. I think Kevin's always been like a really empathetic guy, and that like empathy and sympathy and like caring that he just kind of like exhibits on like a daily basis has probably just only come out in like a greater way. You know, you just see him like how much he like genuinely is stoked on being a dad. And I think realistically, it's probably just like another thing that he gets to be like super into.
I'm trying to think, is that where that left off? Was I just got my board back?
Yeah.
Man, I suppose a lot has changed since then. This fool. Filmed a lot of skating, filmed Baker 4. Had a kid, got married, started working at Baker on like a more full-time behind the scenes art stuff.
No, it's just like a guy doing some yard work.
having a kid has really changed the way I look at time too, because you're watching her just fucking grow up in front of your eyes. And like I was telling you earlier, it's like some days she wakes up and she really is just like cognitively different. She looks different. She's just like, you're like watching that shit happen. It's the biggest cliche, like, that it happens so fast.
Talk to the dogs and the baby all day, that nobody's talking back to me.
You like watch it happen. It's fucked up, dude. You like watch the clock just like spinning. You're like, dude, this rips, but it's... You just found a strawberry.
Do you know who that is?
There's no just like waking up and like seeing where the day takes you kind of thing. It's like make a calendar and stuff and be very deliberate. But that's fucking tight too. Like it's kind of sick to grow up and try and learn new life skills and like transform. It's like, it's fun to learn new shit and become, you know, like evolve.
It's been a full day after that, but it's like then the day just begins. Either go skating or go to Baker or start working on Baker stuff. Or
I feel like what's going on in his brain, he's got like so many things going on in his brain at once that's kind of what comes out in the art. Like, you know, whether it's like Reynolds' face, but he's also thinking about a dolphin. And then there's like a, you know, a skateboard and a ball and a wave. It's like there's 50 things going on in there and somehow they all merge together.
Like Andrew's artistic sensibilities are more minimalist and mine are definitely more like more is more. What's in my head is just like everything, and he's just like very together and organized, and so he's like, let's strip this down. So we used this cloud for like a Baker shirt, and it was on a graphic as well. Andrew was like, I like that cloud guy, and then we kind of fit him into a series that was already going, but that was just some shit I was doodling.
If he didn't put these thoughts like out in a creative way, his head would probably explode.
I'm very lucky that I get to make art, and that is part of what I do professionally, I guess. But it still doesn't feel very serious. It's just like something, it's something that I respect and like care about and want to be grateful to be able to do it. I just have the feeling that I'll be continuing to search for my voice for forever. And I think that that's part of the fun of it, is like not being too precious about like who I am and what I'm making, but still give it the respect to like want to make good shit. It's not like I'm trying to make crap. I want to make stuff that either makes me laugh or feels right, and feels like me, but and feels honest.
That even makes it out skating with all the stuff he has on his plate any like given day of the week. So we've basically just always been filming the past couple years, and then the footage would always go to whatever big project he was working on at the time. And then now that Baker 4 had come out, he hasn't had like a super serious project that's like been needed to come out. I think like Boys of Summer came out, and I'm sure he's had footage and every single little edit he's needed, but we were just filming for the past, you know, year or so, and it was like, hey, like, let's make like a Lottie's video of just Spanky. And then that Lottie's video has now turned into a Baker video.
Even though the maid one, it was like when I was kind of, I was sober and stuff, but I was really finding my footing again physically and like creatively in skating, and really trying to like prove something to myself and probably to everyone else that I still had something left in skateboarding. And it's been years since then, and luckily things have just been going pretty well. So now my tools are a little bit sharper, and I feel like I can just, for the first time in a long time, make a very deliberate skate part that is like spots I want to skate with tricks that I want to see and feel inspired creatively by. And it's just been fun, man. It's just like, it's fun to skate when you feel like inspired.
Get it.
our whole careers, especially people around my age or older, like, has been working towards these video parts, and it's hard to shift away from that. I just always am gonna like want to. I think I'm always gonna want to look back at video parts as like a representation of like wherever I was at in skateboarding at that moment in those years, and like this is just where I'm at right now, hopefully.
It's like family, art, skateboarding is definitely like his life, you know, and that's, I don't think, gonna change anytime soon, but definitely he is like addicted to all of those things.
I hope I don't sound like I'm complaining about all having too much stuff. I really like, I like operating that way. Like, I like having all these things. I'm so thankful to have so much shit to work on and to have like a video part to work on. Like, also, like, there's been times where this is the part, like working on a video part is like so dreaded and some sort of like obligation, but this is just something that we started working on because we wanted to.
Woohoo! 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 Hey, you want some water?